So today I'm going to continue your previous topic. Is known as a mathematical model. Okay. Because I tell you one thing, if you are facing any issues regarding my skin is not visible and my voice is talking and something like that, so then you can tell me. Okay. Okay, guys.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the next method is close. Basically, it is used to check whether values are close. So its close method basically it is used to check whether two values are close or not. For example, like 5 and 5.0, simple or not? Yes, guys.
Yes, sir.
Equal. Okay.
Equal.
So this is the meaning of it's close. Means two numbers are closing to each other. Okay. So I tell you what the syntax of its close method. The syntax is CMath. CMath is a module, and method is C. Sorry, it's close. Okay. I pass two values like 10 plus 5j, comma. N plus 5j. Okay, so what is the outcome coming from this statement? I tell you one thing, when the both number are close to each other, then it returns true, otherwise it returns false. So its statement, tell me what is coming from this statement, true or false?
True, true.
Okay, but what others, true or false? Yes, guys. Give me a response fast. Yes, true, false.
True, sir.
Okay, let's check.
True.
So CMath is not defined. Okay. Okay. So firstly, import my library. Import C. You see, it returns true because the both value are closing to each other, right, guys?
Yes, sir.
So I give you a more example, like CMath dot is close, and at some like 10 plus 5j, comma 10.01 plus 5j. Yeah. Returns true or false? Yes. Yes, guys, true or false?
False, sir. True.
False.
True.
True. Okay. Let's check. So it returns false. Why? Because in this case, this is a 10 and this is 10.01. So this is greater than 10. Okay. Okay. So that's why it returns false. Because the definition is when the both numbers closing to each other, then it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. So in this case, the first number is 10 plus 5j, and second number is 10.01. It means 0.1 is increment. Okay. So that's why it returns false. Now it's clear how the close function is for.
सर
यस
सर प्लीज सर प्लीज अगेन सर, बिकॉज आई एम नॉट अंडरस्टैंड हाउ इट इज वर्क, व्हाई व्हाई वी यूज इस क्लोज मेथड एक्चुअली, प्लीज टेल मी सर.
सॉरी कैन यू रिपीट अगेन.
सर प्लीज रिपीट व्हाई वी
ओके
यूज
ओके
द
ओके
इस क्लोज.
ओके ओके सो बेसिकली इसक्लोज इज अ मेथड इज अंडर सी मैथ मॉड्यूल. सो बेसिकली इट इज यूज्ड टू चेक वेदर टू नंबर्स आर क्लोजिंग टू ईच अदर, देन इट रिटर्न्स ट्रू. फॉर एग्जांपल 5 एंड 5.0, सो बोथ नंबर आर क्लोजिंग टू ईच अदर एंड बोथ द मीनिंग ऑफ बोथ नंबर इज सेम 5 एंड इट्स आल्सो 5, सो दैट्स व्हाई इट रिटर्न ट्रू. व्हेन आई गिव मोर एग्जांपल लाइक 4 4 एंड लाइक 4.5, सो दीज बोथ नंबर आर not closing to each other because the fourth and it is 4.5, so it's greater than 4, so that's why in this case it returns false. Okay, so I give example like this. CMAT dot is closed, so I pass two argument, first is 10 plus 5j and next is again 10 plus 5j, so both number are closing to each other, so that's why return true because both numbers are same, so that's why return true according to definition. Okay, and next is next example is I pass different argument like 10 plus 5j and 10.01 plus 5j, so it returns false. Why? Because in the first variable you see 10 plus 5j, in the second variable you see 10 plus 0.1, so it's greater than 10 plus 5j. Okay, so that's why it returns false. Now it's clear?
Yes sir, yes.
Okay, so let's go ahead and understand some other difference functions. Different function like next method is infinity. Is sorry, not is infinity, is finite. So basically, it is used to check whether x is finite number or number. Yes guys, so anyone can tell me what is the syntax of is finite method? CMAT dot what
is
yes.
Finite
is finite. Okay, is finite. Yes, and we pass some argument or not? Let's try guys. Yes, we pass any argument? Okay, we pass like 2 plus 3j, so it returns because it's a finite, so 2 plus 3j is a finite number. Okay, then next example is CMAT dot finite and pass argument like float inf and plus 5, so it returns false because it's an infinite number. Okay, so INF is the inbuilt keyword. It returns the infinity numbers. Okay, so that's why it returns false because we in this particular method we have to check my number is finite or not. So this number is infinite, so that's why it returns false. Okay, so now clear how the is finite function is work? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So your next method is inf. So basically again it's used to check whether x is positive or negative. In So again, the syntax is same. Cmat dot is inf person complex number complex n plus float pass inf. Okay. So it returns true. Okay. So it's a positive number. And next is we pass like cmat dot is inf. INF like 11 plus 14. Okay, it returns false because when we convert this number, a complex number into a integer, then it's become like a minus. It's a minus negative number. Okay, so that's why it returns false. Okay, so the next method is is NaN. Okay, so basically it is used to check whether x is NaN well, do you have any idea about NaN? What is the meaning of NaN? Basically, it is used to check whether X is NaN. Means, yes, what?
Null.
Null. No.
Maybe.
Sorry?
Maybe null, because in pandas, many times you use npd.nan. It's just maybe.
Yeah, it's a different case. But in this case, the NaN stand for null. But in this case, the NaN stand for not a number. Okay. So, this NaN method is basically used to we find a my number. So, my entire variable is a number or not. Okay. So the syntax is same. Cmat dot is NaN, and we pass 12 plus float. And pass, so it returns true or false? It returns true. Okay. And the next is cmat dot NaN pass complex number 3 plus 2 plus 3j and it returns false because it's a complex number. Okay. So now it's clear. Yes, guys.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next is logarithm function. Log. Next is returns the logarithm. Logarithm of x to be this syntax is cmat dot log and pass argument like 1 plus 1k and you see we get the logarithm value of this particular complex number 1 plus ij. Okay. Now it's clear. Yes, guys.
Yes, okay.
Now give you the next example cmat dot log comma 2.5. Returns 0, 0. Okay. So I think it's clear. So let's move forward and I come in some other function log लॉग बेस्ड है ना। ओके ठीक लॉग बेस्ड है। वेल डू यू हैव एनी नॉलेज अबाउट लॉग बेस्ड एन एंड हाउ इट इज वर्क एंड सम लॉग प्रॉपर्टी? यू डोंट नो देन आई विल टेल यू हाउ इट इज वर्क एंड सम प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ लॉग एंड डेफिनेटली आई विल टेल यू सम लॉग प्रॉपर्टीज। यस गाइस यस एवरीवन नो अबाउट द लॉग एंड इट्स प्रॉपर्टीज। यस गाइस टेल मी गाइस नो और नॉट?
नो सर।
एनीवन नो अबाउट द लॉग प्रॉपर्टीज? यस तनुज सुहास निहारिका एंड सम अदर स्टूडेंट्स
नो सर।
नो। ओके टेल यू सम लॉग प्रॉपर्टीज। तो ना बेसिकली द प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक लॉग एम प्लस लॉग एन इज इक्वल टू लॉग
लॉग एम एन ओके
यस राइट लॉग एन। ओके एंड नेक्स्ट इज लॉग m अपॉन n इज इक्वल टू व्हाट?
लॉग एम माइनस लॉग एन
यस लॉग n माइनस लॉग यस एंड नेक्स्ट इज लॉग x टू द पावर n इज सेम एज
n log x
एन लॉग
n
एक्स
log
यस
एक्स
यस एंड लॉग एक्स। ओके तो ना रिमी द वैल्यू ऑफ लॉग टू विद
जीरो
बेस विद
वन
बेस टेन वन
वन
नो
सर
नो नो
जीरो
नहीं
नो
सर लॉग वन इक्वल टू जीरो।
लॉग वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो या आई नो लॉग वन इक्वल टू जीरो बट इट्स अ लॉग टू। ओके
वन वन
नो
0.3
जीरो
0.3
पॉइंट 0.3 यस एनी अदर आंसर? हु से 0.3
सर
तनुज। ओके सो लॉग टू इज इक्वल टू 0.3040। ओके एंड नेक्स्ट इज लॉग बेस टेन एंड वन लॉग वन इज इक्वल टू
जीरो
जीरो। ओके एंड लॉग टेन इज इक्वल टू
वन
वन
वन यस
वन
बिकॉज द बेस एंड द वैल्यू बोथ आर सेम देन इट रिटर्न्स ओनली वन। ओके एंड लॉग थ्री यस लॉग थ्री
जीरो पॉइंट फोर सेवन
यस यू आर राइट 0.4771। ओके So I will tell you how to find the logarithm value of any variable. Okay, using these properties. Okay, so you note it. These all properties and the value of two and one and 10 and 3. Okay, these are basic values. Okay, using these values, we find the logarithm of any values. Okay, so let's see. Clear the other things. Please mute your mic. Yeah. So I want to find the logarithm value of 20. Okay. And base 10. Okay. But I know about the value of log 2 is equal to 0.3014. Okay. Yes. Using this, you have to find the value of log 20. Yes, guys. Tell me how to find.
Is it true, sir?
Is it? Sorry. Repeat again. Any idea, guys, how to find the value of log 20 with base 10? Okay, so we are using some properties like we have to write 20 like this.
So 1.3040.
1.3040. Okay.
Because there is a 20 means a log m into n means 20. 10 multiplied by 2?
Yes.
So I log m plus n.
Yes, you are right. Yeah. So 20 is like this, 10
multiplied by 2, yes.
Okay. So we follow this property, log m into n. Okay.
Yes.
So log m into n is same like log
m
plus log n. Yes. Log m plus log n. So in this case, we just write log 10.
So base and 10 same, so equal value is 1.
Yes. 10 and value is 2. So base and value both are equal, so it's 1. Okay. Then value of logarithm 2 is 0.3040. Okay. So 1 plus 0.3040. Answer is okay, guys.
1.30103.
Sorry.
1.30103.
Yeah, yeah. 103. Yes. So I think it's clear how to find the value of any logarithm value. How to find the value of any logarithm value of any variable,
sir?
Yes,
one solution log 10 t.
Okay,
divide by log 10.
Sorry, repeat again.
Log 10 t.
Okay,
divided by log 10,
not 20.
So there's two ways to solve this. You can apply there a divide formula or
divide log 10 by log 10.
Yes, sir. Division is also here. Like yes. For example, you have to also try this 100 divided by and some other properties like 100 divided by 5, right? 5 to 10. Yes. You have to also apply this and some other division operation, 50 divided by 2. Okay. Also perform this type of thing. Okay. But multiplication is easy in this case. Right? It's clear, Swaz? Yes. Now it's clear how to find a value, logarithm value.
Yes, sir.
Now, My next question is, log 20 divided by log 10. Log 20 means I think it's another example, right? So my next question is, find the value of log 8 and the base is 2. Yes, guys. Tell me how to find the logarithm value of 8 when the base of log is 2. As I'm not getting properly what I will say, so can you unmute your mic and try to speak what I will say?
Sir, log 20 divided by log 10 equal to 1.30103.
Yes, you are right. Okay, the answer is C. Okay, let's see. Yet, what about this? Yes, guys, it's C or some other
three,
answer?
Three, sir.
Tell me how to find, tell me.
Yes, sir. Three.
Guys, my screen is visible. Okay. Thank you so much for coming.
Yes, sir.
It is same like this. Okay. Divide 3. Okay. So I think you are getting how to find the logarithm value. Okay. I tell you like how to find log base is 2. Okay, guys. So 8. Firstly, we have to break this 8 into base 2. Okay. So 8 is same as what? 2 to the power 4. 4, 5.
3.
What
10?
3. Okay.
3, sir.
3. Okay. So 8 is same as 2 to the power 3. So, okay, 2 to the power, we write 2 to the power 3. Okay. So, we use the power property of log. For example, the base is x and y to the power n. Okay. So, the same as n is comes first. So, n log x and y. Okay. So, in this case, 3 is the power. So, it's come first. So 3 log 2 and 2. And you see the base and the value both are equal. So it's become
4. 1.
Yes.
1.
Yes. So the answer is 3. Okay, guys. Everything is clear till now. How to find the logarithm value of a particular variable. Guys, everything is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now using log 10, how to implement in Python to find a logarithm value of a particular number. So the definition is returns the base log logarithm So the syntax is cmap dot log n it runs one. Okay, got it guys? Using Python is too easy. Just import the library cmap and compute the logarithm map of any numbers. Okay, give me more example. Cmap dot log n and like 20. So you see the value of 20 is 1.3010, exact value guys. Okay, so I think it's easy to find the logarithm of any numbers in Python. Okay guys, any doubt? Yes guys, any doubt?
No sir.
Okay, so I want to find the value of 53. You see, find the value of 53. Logarithm value of 53 is 1.74 and so on. Okay. Okay. My question is, your question is, I want to find the value of 10. Okay, and the base is e. Okay, so how can I do that? Because my base is not 10, 2 and 20, something like this. My base is e. So in previous class I have also told you what is the meaning of e and the value of
e. E raised to 10.
Give me a minute. Firstly, you have to tell me what is the value of E. Yes.
Exponent, sir.
Yeah, it's an exponent.
Log E is equal to 1.
Log E equal to 1, sir.
Log E equal to 1. Why?
It's a property, sir.
Like this.
No, sir. But the log e, e. But the
only. Only.
No, sir. This is one.
No.
Yeah, sir. This is one. Only this will one.
Yeah. Only this is one. This is not one. Okay.
Yes.
Because the base is e, not 10, guys.
Line cut.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. Anyone tell me what is the value of E? Because I have also told you in previous classes.
2.71.
Yes, 2.71. Who is this? Yes.
Rutik.
Okay. Fine. So the base is, so this is basically stand for natural log. Okay. And this same as you see in some mathematical like ln. 10. So firstly we have to convert this log into a this pattern, log base 10 and 10. So it's same as like 2.303 and multiply by log 10 into 10. This is the property, how to convert natural log into base 10 log. Okay guys, so this is value 2.303 and multiply by log 10. So I think you all know what is the value of this. What?
One.
Yes, one. The base logarithm value of 10 is 2.303. Okay. So both log are different. Number one, ln is different, and log, normal log is different. Okay. In this ln case, the base of log is e. Okay, guys. And in this normal log case, the base of log is 10. Okay. So firstly, we have to convert the natural log into a base 10 log. So we just multiply by 2.303. Yes, guys. Now it's clear. What is the difference between natural log and normal log? Yes. Now it's clear, guys. Any doubt till now? Then you can tell me. Yes, guys. Any doubt?
Sir, what is this syntax of to find log base 2 in Python, sir?
Log base 2.
Yes, as you find in vector here, cmat.log 10 and the value is 20. Here, log base, yes, sir. Two, yeah.
Let's see. Firstly, we have to check the log 2 method is available in Python or not. Okay. So, type maths.tab and type log. Okay. So, only the two method, normal log as well as 10 log. So, log 2 method is not available in Python. But let's see. Log 2 method is not defined. So that's why we can't find the logarithm of any value with base 2. Okay, guys.
Okay, sir.
So now everything is clear till now. Yes, guys. Everything is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's move forward and understand some different functions. Phase. So basically, phase is used to it returns the phase of complex number. Guys, I need help because Santosh Mem is not here. So anyone can take the screenshot of this meet for attendance purpose? Anyone? Yes. Yes, guys. Anyone take the screenshot of this meeting? How many students are present in this class?
So far.
Okay. So take the screenshot and send me personally, okay?
Okay, sir.
So the syntax is cmath dot phase. So it's take one argument 2 plus 3j and it turns the phase of complex number. Okay. And next method is polar. It is used to convert a complex number to polar quadrant. Polar quadrant, okay. Syntax is cmat dot polar. And take one argument 2 plus 3j You see, it returns the polar coordinate, means x and y coordinate. Okay. Give me more example. CMAT dot polar, and we pass some other argument like 3 plus 5g, and it returns like this 5.83, and the x value of x and the value of y. Okay. So next method is VACT. So it is used to convert polar coordinate to rectangular. Basically, rect function is used to convert the polar coordinate into rectangular form. So the syntax is remains same, CMAT dot rect, and in this case we don't pass any complex number. So because it's used to convert polar coordinate to rectangular form. Okay, so copy this, pass in this method. Let's see. So it returns 2 plus 2.999 j. So you see, both are same, 2 plus 3 j. Okay, guys. So CMAT, and more example, CMAT dot. I want to find the rectangular coordinate of this. Okay, that's it. Enter, and we get 3.5 j. So you see how to convert a coordinate, polar coordinate, into a rectangular coordinate. Coordinate. Yes, guys.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Yeah. So next and the last method is SQRT. Important, very important. Okay, because we have to find the square root of any number, so then we will use SQRT method. Okay. So the it returns. B square root of x, not x, but by the way, that's it. So that is CMAT dot SQRT equals 4. So it returns 2 plus 0 j. Okay. And I give you more example. CMAT dot SQRT like 25. Okay, so we get 5. Okay, so square root of 25 is 5. Okay, guys, so now it's clear how the SQRT method is working in Python and how to find the square root of any numbers. Yes, guys.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt till now, guys? You can tell me. So today I'm going to next start our next topic, array, but we have not more time, so that's why I'm this topic starting from tomorrow. So your next topic is array. So today I'm going to just give you an introduction on that, what is meaning of array and how it is worked. So basically, you all know about the array, okay? So any idea what is the meaning of array and how it works? Yes, guys. Yes.
Yes, sir. Array is just a linear type of data structure which contains multiple elements, but in homogeneous form. It does not contain heterogeneous, and yes, it and it have indexing to access any element
yes, right. Yes, any other answer? Any different answer? Yes, guys, any different answer?
Array is a collection of data types arranged in the same order, sir.
Collection of data types. Different data type or same data types?
Same.
Okay, right.
Array is located in the same line.
Collection of different data types.
No, not different data type. It's a collection of similar data type. Okay, because it's a linear data set. Yes, any other answer? So the normal definition, yes, you can.
We cannot insert in between the any value in the array.
Okay.
And also pop the elements in between the array.
Yeah, because it's too complex, but we pop the array between arrays, so the indexing is disbalanced.
Yes.
Yeah. So the normal and simple definition of array is, so array is a collection of similar type of data stored linearly and called by same name. Okay, this is a normal and very simple definition. Okay, so Booker's definition is like this: array is a collection of common types of data structure and having element with same data type, and it is also used to store collection of data. In Python programming, an array are handled by the array module. If you create array using the array module, element of array must be the same numeric type. So it's too complex definition, okay guys. So my definition is too simple. The array is a collection of similar type of data and stored linearly and called by same name. Okay guys.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in a Python, we are working on array. So firstly, we have to import the library. Is known as array. Okay. So this array contains two things. Number one, data type. And number two, we pass a list. Okay. Different data type is used in a Python. Like, for example, B is used for signed character data type. And capital B is used to unsigned character. And next is U, small u, is used for var char and Unicode character. And next is H, is used for signed sort character. And I is means for, yes, I is stand for what? Integer or float? Yes, I is stand for int. And next is capital I, so it is known as unsigned int, and it take a 2 byte in a memory. And next is L, so L is used for signed long, so it contain a 4 byte in a memory. And capital L is used for unsigned long int. Okay, it's contain again 4 byte in a memory. And small q, so basically small q stand for signed long int, and is take 8 byte in a memory. Okay, and next is float. So float, anyone have any idea about how much storage storage take in a memory by a float? 2 or 4 byte or 8 byte?
2 byte.
Okay, yes, any other answer?
2 by 2.
A different data type, 2 by 2. Yes, 2 or 4 or 8. So float data type contains a 4 byte in a memory. Okay, and D stands for double float. So it contain a 8 byte in our memory. Okay, guys. So this is just an introduction on array. So I think it's so time is over. So shall we end this session? So if you have any doubt, then tell me, and otherwise you can leave now. Tanuj, you can take the screenshot.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So send me my personal number. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, guys. So if you have no doubt, then you can leave now.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.